Greetings and welcome to episode 28 of my Empire Total War Darth Mod Great Britain campaign. This, my friends, where we left it last time, where the discipline, my friends, the control, the patience has paid off. We are now in a position, or nearly in a position, to begin to sort of plan our own invasion, our own assault on a potential future enemy. Now, we have all of it. The advice has been absolutely exemplary. It really, really has. That includes turning Iceland into a full military base, which means converting the sort of the trade sort of trade port that I did into a full naval port. Definitely be doing that. Many of you saying really sort of convert Iceland into a full military base. So that means the governor's sort of palace is there. That's going to be converted into sort of the military base. You can get the military sort of governor's barracks, as it were, there. So we're going to have, you know, all your advice has been absolutely fantastic, and many of you, the sort of the main theme running through your advice is to get an alliance with France. Now, we can't at the moment get an alliance with France, and here's the reason why. It's because we have an alliance. If we look here, our alliance with, we have Sweden. Now, Sweden are currently allied with France. So the reason we can't get an alliance with France at the moment is because we're allied with the Mughal Empire. And as you can see here, France is at war with the Mughal Empire at the moment, and that is why we cannot get an alliance with France. Now, I'm definitely going to, I think, break the alliance with the Mughal Empire. Keep friendly with them, but break the alliance with them, and then try and get an alliance with France. And as many of you have said, the reason is that is because France can be a very, very powerful ally indeed. It has got an absolute huge swathe of the world under its control. Most of you, Central Europe, Western Europe is under its control. A great swathe of North and South America is under its control. If we were to go up against France now, France would have to turn against us, we would just pretty much be steamrolled. That is how powerful they are. So I think because the Mughals are so distant away from us, if we do sort of break the alliance with the Mughals, if there was any sort of ramifications from that, then at least it wouldn't be as severe as it would if France decided to turn on us and think, hang on, we want a piece of Britain here. We would be very, very hard pressed in which to hold back France. We really would be stretched to the absolute limit. The chances are we would probably fall. That is how powerful France are at the moment. And of course, I'm going to take all your advice, my friends, all of you. And I know many of you have asked to be generals in armies, because we've got a lot of elite armies being built here. Remember, most of these armies have seen every single sort of condition you can possibly. Many of them have been in the Balkans, they've been in Eastern Front, they've been in the Middle East, they've been in the Caribbean. They fought in pretty much every single location you can possibly in the world, and every sort of season, winter, you know, the biting, brutal cold in the sort of the East and the Balkans, Yugoslavia, the blisteringly hot heat in the Middle East and the Caribbean. They have fought every enemy, pirates, they have fought the Western armies, they fought the Eastern armies, they fought the Middle Eastern armies, they have fought everybody. And now what we have got is sort of a hardened core, a veteran core of armies that have just absolutely just seen everything you can possibly see. Hardened veterans now, my friends, all these armies. Many of you have asked to be commander generals of these, and everybody who's asked for one will become a general. Now we've got a number of requests for generals. What I'm going to do is I'm going to specifically put aside sort of the beginning of probably next episode when we sort of launch the attack, before we launch the attack into the enemy, which I'm going to show quite now. We're going to also sort of, we're going to go into sort of some detail of where we're going to go and the sort of the course we're going to take in that invasion. Before that episode starts, I will be naming and putting those generals into place ready. Now that doesn't mean that those of you asked who don't get an army won't get an army. Every single person who asks for an army will get them. But of course I can only produce so many armies, because of course we're still quite restricted by our economy at the moment. It isn't really booming. We've actually pushed Britain to the absolute limit economically. We've actually drawn out every single gold coin we possibly can out of this economy. And of course, until our research catches up, and then of course we can expand again, and the economy will just sort of bloom out from that. But at the moment, we can't just keep hammering out 10, 15 armies at a time. It's just not possible. So those of you who have requested an army that don't get one immediately, you know, in the next couple of episodes, please don't think I'm not going to do one. every person who requests an army will get one eventually. Now, of course, the first armies that come out will, of course, be elite armies because they're getting all the sort of the best troops in it. But that doesn't mean that those armies down the line won't be elite. They will still be mixed with a few elite units in there. And believe me, by the time most of these armies have fought, they will be elite in their own right, even without those elite army units being in there, because the way they have fought, the experience they will gain, they will be elite in their own right. So my friends, first thing we're going to do is we're going to look at Iceland here. We're going to convert Iceland again on your advice, the wonderful advice here. We're going to cancel this. We're going to bring that money back in. We're going to actually burn this down here now. Let's destroy this. Iceland is going to become a fully militarized zone. It doesn't really give us anything else. We've got a farm here. That's fine. We've upgraded the farm and we're pushing everything we can here. But again, this is superb advice, was to remove the government chambers here, make it a military facility here, a full blown military facility, which is what we're going to do. We're going to burn that down as well. I know it seems quite extravagant at the moment, maybe, you know, but we're going to start from the beginning. If we're going to do something, let's do it properly. That is a real thing, I believe, anyway. If you're going to do something, do it properly. Don't do it half-hearted, do it properly. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to put this down. This is going to become a full militarized zone here. Absolutely. But it also allows us to keep away from the prying eyes of the other nations here. Iceland is not very sort of, not I wouldn't say well known, but you don't see many nations sailing past it. You don't see many nations sort of, you know, trying to find out what's happening there. It is a really beautiful location with which to sort of hide your preparations for any future wars or any wars that might come along, even if you don't expect it. It's a good place to retreat to if things get a little bit hairy there in Britain. I think we've got possibly, yeah, well, indeed, we're recruiting here the Royal Irish Regiment and the Royal Irish Regiment here. We're also trying to get our research up to the point where we can get 24-pounders. Now, I think we've got an ordnance board being built in London here. Let's have a quick look. Indeed. Oh, it's already ready, so we can actually produce. Oh, ho, 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 ho. 24 pounders, my friends. 24 pounders are already ready to go here. 448. I think we'll start. Now we've got this money freed up here. I think we'll put that into the cannons. Let's do that. I know we can get lifeguards here, but cannons are equally as important. We'll get four to start with. Give us a good surplus here as well. But also, we don't want to leave these armies just hanging around in these locations here. They're obviously going to be retrofitted. Of course, all these armies are going to be retrofitted with 24 pounders as soon as we can. But also, we need to create armies here that can not just militia armies. We need armies that can garrison sort of the homeland. Proper full-stack armies, fully compositioned in terms of not much cavalry, maybe two cavalry in them. Cannon, but the majority of it also just line infantry. Remember, we're not going to leave sort of what I wouldn't call first class sort of troops defending the major towns of London and Edinburgh, because all you're doing then is you just sort of shooting yourself in the foot, because if someone invades, you don't have a good army to defend your homeland. All of your preparations to attack somewhere else will be in vain. It means you've got to pull back all your best troops from wherever they are to defend the homeland. We might as well have a proper army defending London and Edinburgh and pull these armies out so they can be part of sort of the assault force. But let's do things properly, my friends, if we're going to do things. Let's really do them properly. Again, your advice has been absolutely wonderful. It really has been exemplary once again, my friends. Now, what we are going to do, and just look at the size of France. I mean, it is absolutely scary. They've absolutely butchered Poland here. But Poland have made a slight comeback here. But Poland, my friends, Poland is our target here. Not here. As many of you said, man, be very careful what you're doing here, because you'd be stuck between Prussia and, indeed, Russia and remnants of Poland if I was to attack Konigsberg here. We've got to be very, and indeed France, we'd be caught within this sort of, this triumvirate of nations here that really could, if they decided to take this office, they would crush us with ease. They really would. You've even got this army here in a port here of Memel that would probably give us enough trouble, let alone the garrison in Konigsberg. So no, we strike the underbelly, the weak spot here. But we're sending in a spy up here to just have a quick glance around and see what's happening here. But mind you, France has absolutely got a bucket load of troops here. Look at this, absolutely loads of troops here. So we really need France to be on our side here in terms of alliances. But the soft underbelly, my friends, of the Polish Empire is here. Greece, Istanbul, we can even possibly take the Ottoman Empire if it so suits us. We really got to be careful though. Who are the Ottoman Empire's allies? Do they have any allies? Indeed, Russia and the Mughals. So we're not going to be attacking the Ottomans unless they attack us. But here it is. Let's just get this sorted. As you can see, we've got Athens, an absolute crucial hub here to the sort of the beginning of the Mediterranean Sea. Then, of course, you've got Istanbul as well there. These two really do form the absolute apogee here, the pinnacle of Polish sort of power in the south here, in the Mediterranean, and indeed moving on sort of the Crimea, the Baltic, the Black Sea. And then, of course, you've got the Yugoslavia, the Balkans, you've got Bulgaria, Serbia, Bosnia, Transylvania, and then you're sort of moving slowly into sort of Moldova as well. And but then when you Galicia and Podolia, then you're looking at, you know, moving into the eastern front, as it were, the sort of the, you know, the eastern sort of European countries as they would be now. And so moving on then, of course, you've got Minsk, which is effectively now Russian, Vilnius again Russian, and Königsberg, which is sort of, you know, that sort of that German tip of sort of where they sort of their power ends, as it were. Of course, Gdansk, Western Prussia, if you combine those together, you've got a full Prussian front there. But as you can see, we really could absolutely do ourselves an absolute service here by taking Athens and Istanbul are going to be our main goals here. As many of you said, attack them both simultaneously. And that way then you can sort of have two massive sort of power bases, both of them are walled settlements, so that gives you a really firm defensive fortification here immediately, especially if you've got Russians here in Ankara. If you notice there, the Russians are there in Ankara. If they were ever to kick off, or, you know, be really unhappy with what we're doing there with the Poles, we could hold up the Russians in Istanbul, probably indefinitely, because Istanbul is such a tough city to break. They would have to throw a huge amount of forces at us to break Istanbul. In the meantime, we'd be able to get reinforcements from Athens and vice versa. So that's pretty much, my friends, the whole thing. Also, Malta. Malta has come up quite a lot, as we should take Malta. Now, Malta really is a pretty key, important, and I agree with you, I think we might take Malta. It really has got that strategic value, very important strategic value here, as you can see, right in the heart of the Mediterranean, between sort of North Africa and indeed sort of the Balkans and Italy. It really does give you that sort of stepping stone, and also a retreat. If you can retreat back from sort of Athens and Istanbul, if things really go terribly wrong for us, then Malta might be the stepping stone we need. First of all, we need to see what sort of allies the Maltese have. So let's have a quick look here what Malta have in terms of allies. Where is Malta? Nice to St. John. Protectorates of Prussia. That is a problem right there. So Malta could be off the cards at the moment. We have to keep our enemies, you know, really sort of singled down into sort of a certain set. Let's have a look who Poland are allied with. Just Genoa here. Genoa are here. Do they have anything else? Genoa of Corsica as well. That might mean, and no, they've only got those. That might mean us having to pretty much blockade Gibraltar here to keep the Genoans coming after us. Mind you, we probably need two fleets. One fleet to protect the homeland, another fleet to probably protect the assets here, because Genoa will definitely attack us if we attack Poland. But we're gonna have to probably keep a fleet here to guard sort of the opening here from Mediterranean into the Black Sea. The Russians are loitering here. Not a powerful force, but still enough to concern anybody, especially with three grenadier regiments in here. And a pretty decent general as well. So these gentlemen here have seen a little bit of action. Istanbul is pretty well defended here, especially with the grenadier regiments and riflemen and the guards unit here. Right. Our preparations begin forthwith. We really do now. We're going to put quite a lot of our money here. What have we got coming in? 10,000 here. Probably because the Ottoman Empire has been hit, Sweden's been hit, and Prussia's been hit. So we're going to try and make the most of what we can here. How's our research? 6 turns here until we get machine tools and we get Wealth of Nations. It's going to take, actually, we get a free doctrine. It's going to take 9 turns. Carbines. Do we need carbines? Oh yes, we need Tarleton's Light Dragoons and the 16th Light Dragoons. That's a wonderful sight. The bloody ban. We're countering enemies to skirmish and artillery, so definitely want to get these gentlemen. So carbines will persist in research there. We want to try and get quick lime as well, as quickly as we can, no pun intended. But at the moment, things are progressing well here, but we do need to replace these armies with sort of line infantry and predominantly artillery, with one or two cavalry units in here. So we are going to be building up quite a lot here towards our campaign aim, which is to take Poland. We've also got this army here, which can be withdrawn at the earliest opportunity as well, because as soon as we've got enough militia, because Iceland, although important strategically in terms of where it is, it's not as vital as Britain. So we're not going to leave an absolute super army here. And we're going to pull this army out, and it's going to be brought back here to this army group. We could probably form two army groups. We're probably going to need these two army groups to attack Poland. So we've got to build towards that, and also have two armies being built or built before we leave. Right, we've got 10,000 here, so our army upkeep has shot up quite significantly here. I believe our... Oh my gosh, look at that Justice Minister. That is exceptional. I know it's even that is wonderful here. Navy, Army... Oh my gosh, the Army Secretary of War is wonderful there. America's not brilliant, but then again, America really isn't our sort of goal, our focus at the moment. So we need to break the alliance with the Mughals. Now, that might not go down very well at all. They're very friendly with us here, but to be honest with you, let's see what they think of that. Now, they're unfriendly with us, but what we will do is we will send them... We can't at the moment. We're going to send them a state gift. We send them a technology. No, we send them a payment. We offer them 500, just to sort of, as one of you also recommended, send them a payment. Just send them that. Ah, very well done, my friends. A beautiful piece of advice there. We send them some 500 gold just to keep them on our side. But I think we can end the turn now. We can definitely see what's going on here with France and Poland here. Let's see what happens. Nothing yet, but as you can see, Warsaw is possibly going to be reinforced. Spain. Can we friendly with Spain? We have to be very wary of the Mughals here. What I'm doing, I know I cancelled that alliance with the Mughals and didn't get the alliance with the French in a way. I just want to give it till now, until this... all the other nations have done what they want, and then ask for the alliance. It just gives them that time to sort of things to balance itself out. Now Russia is on the move, but Sweden is going to possibly be absolutely crushed. The Mughals, now they've left us alone, so we'll leave them alone. Now still friendly with us, only plus 59 now, which is fine. Spain is indifferent, but again, can we get an alliance here with France? They're at war with the Mughals. If the Mughals were to attack us, they would definitely get involved in that. Oh no, we can't. What? Ah, Louisiana. Of course, Louisiana, right. So it looks like we've got to try and get peace with Louisiana. Otherwise they're not going to take it. So they're hostile with us. We request peace. We'll offer them carbines, measuring, spinning jenny, speed, anything. We've just got to try and really sort of hit them with everything we got here. No, they really don't like us at all, do they? Drats. Request peace. What if we do offer them this? No, they're just not interested one iota. Nah, that's not gonna... That is really not going to be good for us, because we've only got allied with... We're only allied with Sweden. And they're also allied with Sweden. It's because we're at war with Louisiana. I wonder if we were to... No, and if we were to give them all of these as well. I know it's quite severe, but it'll just give us peace. No, but they're not interested at all. what we are going to do then is we're going to try and get that alliance back with the Mughals. No, they don't like us now. They really don't want to bother with us. That's fair enough. Right. Do we have to deal with the Louisianans then? We could take Louisiana out, but it just... And maybe if we could take Louisiana out and then give it to the French. Mind you, that is not going to be good for us. It's going to take us away from... It's going to take us away from where we want to be, isn't it? Right, let's look at these gentlemen. Look at that. What a magnificent looking army here. Well, we've done one thing. We need to keep the Mughals... Well, we'll break the lines with the Mughals. If we can, we will try and get peace. I wonder if they would... I wonder if we give them the Windward Islands. We've gotten rid of the pirates. If we did give them the Leeward Islands here... Mind you, that's bringing into us 8... No, that's need 2,000. We'll miss that 2,000. We need that 2,000. So, no. If France don't like it, then maybe in the future we can get something done with France. But at the moment, we're not going to worry about the alliance, my friends. But I definitely take your advice. If the opportunity arises in the future for us to take the alliance with France, I'll definitely do that. But at the moment, we're pretty... Well, it's only plus 37 with France. We could always send them a state gift of 2,500, that is, because, my word, they are absolutely as scary as you could possibly imagine. But they're at war with the Mughals, so that's fine. And they're also at war with Poland. Again, which is good for us. If we were to go into war with Poland, that would also improve our relations with them. So let's focus on what we really need. 17,000 here. 12,917. 77. Excellent. Sorry, sir. Right. Oh my gosh, we can still recruit. This is wonderful to see. Gunnery school. Oh, ideally, I'd like to spend the money here on these settlement fortifications. I think it's probably best we get this done sooner rather than later. We need to really fortify Britain absolutely to the nth degree here. So we're actually going to put settlement fortifications on the production line here. We've got lifeguards here. We actually need to start... So these guns here will be replaced... 3,000 here for a gunnery school, which will bring us up to that. Ideally, we do need to, mind you, we'd probably be better if we get the Highland Grenadiers here. And then from here, two of these gentlemen. No, gentlemen, please. Thank you. 1,182 here. So I think that's pretty good at the moment. We definitely need to increase our ship numbers. We are going to... And also, many of you said get rid of your weaker, smaller ships. So as sort of, especially these here, these fifth raters, we might put them into another fleet. So what we might do is have this fleet here as absolutely an elite fleet. Of course, victories there, what a beautiful sight. And then what we'll do, we'll put these ships here, because they've got quite a bit of experience. We'll put these into this other fleet here, which will sort of guard Britain. Unless we just switch them around here. Of course, so what we'll do is we'll move... Remove. Mind you, these are pretty experienced ships. I move this one up to here. On our way, Captain. And then this navy here. Well, actually, we move down to here. All these ships. So that completes a pretty exceptional sort of fleet here. We might even replace some of these. These two here were replaced with. Some other first raiders. Let's have a really proper fleet to really do what we need to do. We also need to get some sloops to be able to sort of move these troops. So what we're going to do, we're actually going to recruit some sloops here. Two sloops. Three sloops. Let's get them while we got the money. What we got here? 12,977. Excellent. And of course, Iceland, how is that doing here? Is that faring? So we can now get a shipyard next turn, and also here we're also going to build a magistrate here. Everything's got to be done in proportion and at the correct time. Patience, my friends. Patience has paid off here. It's paid dividends. Look at that. Poland has got a massive army there outside Warsaw. And look at that. They're building quite the army here. They might even push France back from Warsaw eventually. I wouldn't be surprised at all, to be honest with you. But that doesn't mean we shift from our goals. Oh, look at that. That just suddenly appeared right there. Russia. Sweden, Spain, Mughal, Genoa, Westphalia, nothing at all, everything is... That's a lot. Oh, that is fantastic. So we're going to retrofit this army here. For this army. Fantastic, look at that. These gentlemen are now going to be disbanded. $27,000, look at that, it's gone up. Trade is absolutely booming here at the moment. We've got the scoop for the Irish regiment, which is going to be pulled from here and moved to the mainland. We have an elite army being built here, recruited should I say. Got a settlement fortifications. Somerset House, ooh, engineering school. That'll give us £24. See, we don't need that at the moment, but it'll give us percussion shells and shrapnel shot eventually, but we do need to focus on what we're doing here. Oh yes, wonderful. But no. Oh, these died. We've lost our ability to spy on them there. Not to worry, he did his job. He managed to get us to at least see this here. We will get another rake, we'll get another spy very soon. And I think definitely what we need to do here is to move up magistrates here and also here a shipyard. Go move up to a dry dock. Let's get this naval base moving in with all haste. How's our research here? Four more turns. Excellent. Oh, of course, modern university. That would push our research up. But we'll wait for this one to finish first before we invest in this here. Now here, I'm not going to invest in that because that's more than enough. Gunnery school. I think if we're going to push on here to in terms of our military, we need to invest in what we can while we've got the money. Two more lifeguards. And also a first rate. Let's invest while we've got the money coming in. I know it would be hit pretty hard if we got 10,000 from other. That is fantastic. When we get Louisiana on our side, we'd get an alliance with. Wow, they don't like us at all, do they? Let's give them everything we got here. Nope, not just not interested in it. One iota. But the Mughals, would they be? They got all the technology, they don't need our technology. What is Sweden? Rights of man. Oh, they got quicklime. No good sir, that will never happen. What if we give you rights of man for 1,000? Excellent, 1,000, thank you sir. Again, your advice has been wonderful my friends. The technology, they've got all the technology. They're going to be pretty formidable. Oh, Prussia. They've got all the technology as well. I think we're way behind most of these. Other nations, yeah, they've got everything, so we just got to keep ours firing as best we can here. This navy, I think what we will do is we'll put... I think we'll keep these faster ships in here. What's their... Actually, the movement speed is low. So I might move these 4th raters into this fleet here that will guard Britain. 1,800. Definitely we need to move this fleet down to here.
Orders received and understood.
Okay. Everything's good, everything's done here. That's upgrading. We've got a new shipyard being built here. We're going to move to a military governor's barracks here. We've got a military barracks, should I say. And everything else in at the moment, calm and peaceful, is what we need. Okay, let's end. We've got coming in 13,000. Ministers looking good. Popularity is good. Trade is okay at the moment. Prussia's come back on, that's why we got that increase. Let's end the turn and see what happens. We've got to keep an eye on what's going on down here in this sort of tussle between France and Poland. It's important to us. Spain. They're not entirely friendly with us, but then again, Poland, Lithuania, what are they up to? What are they up to exactly? Ottomans, Russia. Sweden. Locales, Venice. Genoa, everybody else just nice and calm and peaceful. Ooh, excellent. That's gonna boost us there. Yes, indeed it has. Oof. Really? Really, sir? Oh, look at that. Ooh, look at that. This won't be the full composition of this army. Remember, these troops are just being sort of positioned here. This army will not look like this. These troops will be moved between several different armies, but I'm bringing them together in sort of a camp just outside London, just so they can, once they're all here, they can then be distributed to the specific armies. This army will not be composed of all of these troops. These troops will be split between several armies here, because, you know, we don't want to husband all of our elite forces into one army, because if that army was to get destroyed, it would pretty much, we would lose that firepower the elite units give us. Those elite units will be distributed among several armies, just to give those armies that extra oomph. Geneva's school. Nope. Right, let's have a look what's done here. Roads are finished. Nothing else is finished yet. That's one more turn, so we've got a few more turns yet. Actually, probably best we got. We can't actually build and recruit any men just yet, not until we get those barracks up and running. 15,000 here. So I think what we will do is we're going to, again... Oh, look at that heavy first rate there. That's a beautiful ship. I think we'll get that there. Got to keep our navy strong, because the other navies around here are exceptionally strong. Should we get engineering school and absolutely kit out everything here? To get platoon firing, it'll give us army staff college. Not until we've got those to get those dragoons. Ottoman are probably indifferent with us now. -8 for the Ottoman Empire. Friendly. Very friendly, very friendly. Russia is only just... Yeah, Russia's still friendly with us. We definitely got to watch ourselves here. We want to make sure we're prepared for this. So we'll get the engineering school here. Let's start recruiting some more 24-pounders. 4 more 24-pounders. But we'll keep a small bank here. Sorry about that, my friends. phone call then. So we're going to recruit these so we can retrofit this army here, and also fit this army out with some as well, and probably this army in London as well will need, yeah, retrofitting as well indeed. So that's what we're going to do here. Remember, this is, we're just taking our time here. We don't want to push out to Poland just yet. We're going to make sure we've got armies here. Actually, we're probably best if we actually start recruiting some of these armies for the home front. Let's get that in preparation. So I'll be left out on a limb. 13579. Let's end the turn again. Let's see what happens here. We're assembling the armies here, preparing ourselves. What is Courland doing down here? And what's France doing? Russia's here. Russia is it? What's Poland up to? Wait a minute, have they taken Warsaw back? They've taken Warsaw back. Whoa, the plot thickens. Fleet here. Oh, that's gone down a tremendous amount there. Why? Our Prussia's been hit again. Who is hitting Prussia? Oh, Courland again. Brilliant. But look at that, they've taken Warsaw back off the French. Could the French be, could we see the French collapse potentially? But at the moment we're not, we're going to go for Poland. Things are going to stay exactly as they are. Reykjavik, Governor's residence. Can we actually get a? Don't tell me we can't get a military barracks here. Well, if we can't, pike, medium men, no, 2,500 here. On this port, what we'll do is we'll concentrate on upgrading this here first, and then we'll upgrade this. Oh, Naval College, we're ready to go here. Two more turns. First two regiments of the army to defend and hold London. So I think we can move this army out of here. Join here. Oh, look at that. They're not happy in their London at all. Clamour for reform. Clamour for reform is very high indeed. Food shortages. Immigration to the colonies. Tax burden. Look at that. Look at that. Food shortages. How can they have food? Mind you, we've got a lot of armies here. So, I think we definitely need to recruit two more regiments here. Actually, this is not too bad here in Edinburgh at all.
Yes, sir.
Actually, we sent them down. They should be sent back up to Edinburgh. And we're going to recruit two more. Gunnery school is on its way. Got 7,000. I think once again we should increase our. Why do we get a? Get one of these first rates here, and sloop. We have our fleet of sloops ready to go with us. We'll also need to take this fleet with us. But we need to stiffen the fleet that's going to be defending the homeland, as it were. We've got settlement fortifications. Almost ready here, almost ready here. Research, not too far off either. Oh, look at that, minus 10%, 8% bonus town wealth. Ceramics and lumber mill, which we can't really get, but that's not the point. It will open up this steam engine. That'll allow us to really push our economy absolutely motoring ahead here then. I just wish that some of these Ottoman Empire, I wish that Sweden and I wish Prussia would get its act together and kick Courland out. But of course 2193 here. Look at that, Poland have retaken Warsaw here from the French. That is a big thing there, right there. That's a big event. Some of you also saying maybe you should take the Sweden out here, the Copenhagen. But ideally I'd like to keep Sweden there. They're sort of the backstop for Russia. We want to really look, and they've got some pretty good units here as well. That's some pretty solid units right there. That's a pretty strong army. They're actually stopping Russia from really sort of steamrolling around, but they've taken Christiania here, Norway. They're the sort of they're holding back the Russians from taking what would be probably their one first step into sort of Western Europe proper, as it were. Okay, let's end the turn, my friends. Let's see what happens here. See what Poland does to France. Will France hit back against Poland? That really is the key here. Let's keep an eye. Something's going on here. No, they haven't. But what will Poland do to France? Poland, there it is. Poland. What are they going to do? Will they take any more territory off France? Will France suddenly start shrinking? Hang on a minute. Did they just take that there? And Russia, what's Russia going to do? What are Russia going to respond? Savoy, Mughal Empire, Pueblo Nation, Venice, Afghanistan, nothing. Yes, it's up and running. That is a lot. That is a lot of military movement here. Now, we definitely have to make sure. So what we're going to do is we're going to pull this ship out of here and combine it into the home fleet. And this moved into the exploration fleet. Acheron, look at that, wonderful. Now,
sir, your honor, Lord, your humble servant, your majesty.
Ready, moving back up to here.
Forwards, ready and awaiting your country.
Shall join here. That's more like it. We've only got two here. Despite it, mind you, these are going to be pulling out to retrofit.
Any further orders?
Down to one. So looks like we have to recruit more. Actually, I think we'll get two heavy cavalry regiments here. Oh, and also dragoons. Many of you have seen dragoons are good for keeping the populace under control. So in fact, we'll get the cavalry here. We get two light dragoons. I think we get two dragoons here. Again, your advice has been exemplary. And we need to retrofit these armies. So this army here is going to be
by the left, your majesty. Awaiting further
orders. Oh, that's more like it.
Lord, at the ready.
And then this army here will be getting Get that one in there. We need one more here to fulfil this commitment to retrofitting these. Are going to be disbanded. We don't need them. Go watch that cost, that money cost. Look at that, that spiralled hugely. 31,000 the army upkeep. We're really putting its toll on the economy at the moment. Corland is hitting here. They're hitting the Swedes pretty hard. And actually they've got that back. Prussia's got that opened up again. Wonderful. But Sweden has been absolutely bamboozled here by Corland. Did they take this here? Oh, I don't believe they've taken Breslau. I thought they'd taken something here. They've taken Breslau. That means they've pushed the French right back here to sort of the German border, as it were, in Hungary. Oh my God, could we see Poland rolling up the French? In which case, we could be attacking France here. Even though they've got this massive sort of colony here, in here, if we were to take them, we would be pretty secure, even if they were to attack us. Mind you, we could hit Poland. We still hit Poland. But they would be able to push in it. Oh my gosh, look at the armies they're building down here. We're going to have to be absolutely on our best military behaviour here in terms of what we do here, because this is going to be prove vital to what we're doing here.
Your orders, Your Majesty.
I'm going to start moving some of these armies about soon. But first of all, let's just move them into some kind of proper coherent position here.
Waiting for orders, Your humble servant. Troops, forward!
Your Majesty.
By the left, march!
We've got here, how many... This army can be pulled out. We need to retrofit this army as well.
By the left, at the ready!
15, that's good enough. We're going to move these down, back down to Britain, into England, beg your pardon, just outside London. I'm going to start forming the core of these two army groups. We've already got an army group established pretty much here. We need a second army group to really give us that oomph. We've got 10,000 here. So we're going to need 6 sloops. 2 more sloops. I think we'll get one more heavy first rate. How's the research? 1 left on each of these, that's fantastic. What about Reykjavik here? Again, we're not going to put into that, we're going to wait for this one to be finished. We're going to bring this up to a naval hospital as quickly as we possibly can. And as soon as we can upgrade these buildings here, I mean, look at that, it's going to give us a massive amount of economic boost here. London is now well defended. Somerset House is almost ready. That's going to give us a pretty big boost to our internal economy there. Engineering school is quite a ways off yet. But we're starting to put together that. But we're going to watch here with interest what happens with Poland. Will Poland absolutely push the French back? If they do, we might be able to strike against France. Who's France allies again? Oh, they've got Sweden, Westphalia, Spain. We could be going to war with Spain, which would really push us to the limits here, because Spain can field some exceptional armies here. So be careful what we're doing, they've got some pretty massive fleets. Look at that army there, that is a pretty large army in that port. Or we might even come to France's aid against Poland. That would put us in their good books. The Protectors of Louisiana. We just can't get Louisiana to forget the past. It's actually going up. Let's see if we can make some payments. And let's give them some technology. They loathe and detest us, so we're not going to bother again. That's the last time we bother with that. We are not going to be giving them anything else. If they want a war, they want to fight, then I'll be more than obliged to help them out here with that fight. Right, let's recruit here, and also with... We don't actually, Edinburgh's under pretty much good control here, so we'll just have some heavy cav here for that. Right, let's end the turn. Let's see what happens. We have two sets of research finishing now, but our armies are starting to build here now. They're starting to come together, this strike force. We can do this. We can do this. Will France be able to hold on to the eastern holdings here? Poland. Mind if Poland does roll up France, that means we can then strike into Poland, Polish territory, from where we are, hopping across the channel and hitting them pretty hard. Doesn't look like they've taken anything else. It looks like France have held them at bay here. But Russia, will Russia make that final stride into Sweden? No. Afghanistan. No! The king is dead. Long live the king. King George I. It's actually not too bad, so it's not as bad. 64, next election is only 3 turns of next election. It's going up. Prussia's been hit again. They just can't seem to get themselves into shape. We need this 15,000, that's gone down trade. Your national leader, George the First. Move out.
Yes, Your Majesty. Officer, on deck.
Actually, I think it's probably best we do keep the home fleet reasonably aye, aye, strong. So actually, we'll put that ship into there.
Shipshape and Bristol vacuum, Captain.
Scotland has got now a pretty... Yeah, that's good. We do need a full army in here. We're not going to skimp at all on our troops we've got here. What's the army looking like? Got two of those here. We definitely need cannons. Well, actually, we could probably move the cannon from one of these armies here instead of getting rid of them. Do we still have any cannon left? Got a cannon here. Oh, wait a minute. This cannon, these two cannons can actually be sent back up to Scotland. This army can be moved back in... Oh, look at that. Just outside Portsmouth here. We have the cannon here.
Your Majesty.
We also need a general, so one of our generals has died as well. Lewd. Yes, he has. Drats. So we should recruit our general here. So we need two. We need two more additional cannon. So I have two cannon in there. We shall get some additional troops here, and also definitely here in London. Right. Ottomans are still indifferent. They're plus 5 now. Spain are friendly now. They're back friendly, which is fine. Right, let's do our research. We definitely want steam engines. Well, we definitely want platoon firing, so that's excellent. We've got those there. That's ready now, so next time we'll probably invest in that there. Ooh, 6958. That's a pretty big hit we've taken there. We just need this here, the steam engine, to be pushed through. Oh, wait a minute. Get free trade doctrine. Oh, look at that. Secular humanism. And citizenship. No, we're going to go for that. Free trade doctrine in classical economics as well. Yes. Right. We need four more cannon. And actually, what we will do is we'll put these two 12-pounders into London. It's coming under more under control now, London. Why have they got food shortages here? They shouldn't have. We've got a lot of food coming in. Let's have a look what's happening here on this frontier. Breslau's fallen. We haven't got a rake here at all to look at what's going on, which is a real shame. But Poland have really pushed back the French under that French army there. That's a massive French army. We could take Königsberg. We could really hit the Poles pretty hard here. We have to be very, very careful what we're doing here. Very careful indeed. Let's end the turn. Spain. Prussia. Poland. What will Poland do here? Will they use Silesia here as a sort of a springboard into, you know, more hitting more into Central Europe here? Because that would be a massive undertaking. It really would. I don't have done anything else at all. Russia. Sweden, nothing at all. Savoy. Mokals, they're fine with us. And also, the recommendation was take the Inuits out, which we could definitely possibly look at doing at some point. And again, how are we looking here? 7182. 14, almost got 15,000 in tax income. That's kind of, the trade's gone up, luckily. And we're starting to push our economy now pretty strongly here.
Where to, Captain? Aye, sir.
Scotland is not looking too bad at all. That's looking pretty good here. We have a general, I think, in charge here. That'll give the armies a little bit of extra zeal. And also should bring air for these dragoons here are doing well. It's looking too bad at all, is it? Is anyone else, any more armies got any more cannon?
Make ready. Sir, your orders? Your humbles. Ready for orders.
There it is. That's going to be moved into London.
Order.
It's going to be moved out.
At the ready.
Yes, my lord.
Into there, into this. Look at that, the composition is now coming together beautifully here. We're going to have to start moving some of these troops around here eventually. So we have these elite troops intermixed. That's a really powerful strike force here. Can't get more lifeguards. Ideally we do need the ordnance board. £24, we're going to chunk some money back here. Oh yes. Oh, military governor's encampment, there it is. I think we'll go down this route here. Naval hospital, That's a big spend right there. Do we invest in the naval hospital here? Or do we wait for steam dry dock? Plot thickens. Steam engine. Pretty powerful. Wait for the steam engine to be finished. We could wait for the steam engine to be finished and make that a steam dry dock. That would be pretty potent. Actually, we need to probably pull this army out of here. That's well under control. What happens if we pull this army out? And we can begin recruiting here. What if we pull this army out? Things are under control. That's good. That's 8 prisoners for occupation. I think we can probably move this army out of here now, as we need to do. Let's move them to here, and let's get them back to Britain. They can be retrofitted as well. Their guns can be used in the army's defending England. I know we got Dublin here, but we can still send forces across.
Still ship shape. Make ready. Set sail.
Oh yes, we definitely retrofit this, but we've got a real powerful strike force here. I think we've probably got enough here, to be honest with you, to do what we need to do. And that is to move out and attack. What we do, we'll take these 3 regiments out of here. And they'll actually be put into... What have we got here? We'll send 1. We'll send 2 up to Scotland.
Immediately. Yes,
and this additional 1 will be sent into London. 1 more to Somerset House. 2 more to Engineering School. Wonderful. Nothing happening here. This will probably be the last turn number. There's not much happening here, but we've positioned ourselves now ready. The armies are now ready to be put into action. Whatever happens next turn, we will be striking against Poland. What are Poland going to do? I don't believe it. They just taken something else? I thought they might have taken something else then. They really are pushing hard, Poland. Wow. What are they up to? Nothing. Ottomans. They're not taking anything else here at all. Looks like they've just sort of that front line is eased, is calmed. Russia, what are you up to? Nothing. Sweden, Louisiana. Courland. Somerset House is ready. Oh, 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 it's ready, look at that. 14, 486, 20,000 here, 34,000 army upkeep. We've got the Somerset House now. There, look at that.
Your Majesty?
To Scotland.
Forward. Yes, sir.
This army is now going to be...
Forwards! Sir! March! Forwards! March! Sir!
Got 3 cannon which are going into that army. They've been earmarked for that first.
Troops! Forward! Your Majesty?
This army here needs to be retrofitted with 4 cannon, by the looks of it.
Yes, sir. Your humbles. Ready for orders. Ready and awaiting orders.
So it looks like we need 4 cannon. 4 howitzers, I beg your pardon. Iceland is going to require some more militia. Governor's encampment. We can go up 1 more again after that as well. So give us some excellent troops in Iceland as well. A full military camp here in Iceland. We want to try and save some money. We might want to put some money in the bank here. I think we must just try and get another. God, that's it. Has that actually come down or has it gone up? We'll actually get one of these. I think we're the cheaper first rates here. I'll try and put some money in the bank. Whoa, that has dropped like an absolute stone. And why is that? Four, eight, five, six. That's why, because our outgoings are absolutely ballooning out of control. So we're going to have to strike hard now against... We've got a huge amount of money coming in. If we... If we lose Poland as a... provider, that's going to hit us really, really hard indeed. But we've got to make sure these armies are retrofitted. It's as simple as that. We have to make sure they're in good stead. In fact, we'll probably just give that one three cannons. Then go up to there. I think then we... Oh, look at that. And then I think what we can do is then what we will do then next episode is we'll start distributing these elite armies, elite regiments, I beg your pardon, into these armies. Look at this one, he doesn't have any elite regiments at all. This will get that. We can actually... Oh, beg your pardon. Sorry about my friends, my phone. We'll also have to try and recruit better horse here because we don't really have that. We want these to be heavy cavalry, which will really do the most damage. We've still got quite a bit of work to do here on these armies. A lot of these need retrofitting. Even though these cavalry have been experienced. To be honest with you, if we're going to go for it, we need the best armies we can get, and that means getting rid of these and bringing in some heavy cavalry, which I think we're going to do. So we've still got some retrofitting to do here, and also we'll do it up here as well. That's that. Our income's going to be hit hard here, but we've just got to do it, my friends, because the attack we're going to launch is going to be pretty brutal here, and it's going to really test our mettle here, particularly here in Istanbul. But if we can get Istanbul, it would be a wonderful sight to get Istanbul. It really would. And also, if we take Athens, it would immediately give us a massive boost to our income. Look at that, steam-powered. All of Greece would be ours. I know how we'd have that, but then we'd be helping France. We're taking the pressure off France as well, which would be absolutely fantastic. But my friends, I'm going to end this episode here. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, please comment, like, and subscribe. And as always, my friends, please keep your comments coming down below. They've been absolutely fantastic. They really have. They literally have enabled us to get where we are now, and they really have shaped this episode as well. As you could see, all of your comments I've been able to, and all of your plan strategies I've been able to sort of incorporate most of them into this. If you don't see them happening straight away, they will be done further down the road. But again, absolutely wonderful advice. Can't thank you enough, my friends. But next time we will, if we're not attacking next episode, we will be at least moving our forces into position next episode, ready to strike. We're going to just reform, change a few things, get rid of a few cavalry regiments and put the heavy cavalry into it, you know, and then put some of those elite regiments in some of the armies. We're going to name the armies, and then we're going to go on our way into Poland, and we're going to really go for Greece, and we're going to go for Istanbul at the same time. We're going to really go for it now. How many armies we got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We got two army groups, and we've also got enough armies here to defend England and Scotland from pretty much anybody deciding to attack us here. So, you know, we're not doing too bad considering the restraints on our economy. Mind you, this is going to push our economy to the absolute limit here. But still, it'll balance itself out eventually. But if we can just take Greece, if we can just take Istanbul, it'll give us such a massive, massive boost. It really will to our income, a massive boost to our income. But ideally, I think we probably need to try and keep some money back next time around, because we want to make sure that we can repair these cities once we take them. And actually, whoa, they've taken Moria here. Now that does change things substantially. So Poland have taken Moria. So we could actually take... I wonder if we could take Patras. what we need to do is do this. We're going to send in a scout ship. Oh, don't tell me you're getting past here. Ah, oh, look at that. Damn. Russia's in the way, but we'll still send a scout ship down that way, and Russia will eventually move. So what we'll do is we'll send a scout ship down this way here. Oh, wait a minute. Where is that lead? Where is that going? But as soon as we get a chance, we're going to move across here. As soon as Russia gets itself out of its way, out of the way here, we're going to be moving in and we're going to be testing this. If we can't get past the blockade by Russia, what we will be doing is we'll be attacking Königsberg and going for Warsaw at the same time. So we'll be pushing straight through and, you know, taking all of this as much as we can in the eastern frontier. We can always adapt our plans. But my friends, I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, please comment, like, and subscribe. And as always, my friends, keep your comments coming down below. Please keep those comments coming down below. They've been absolutely fantastic. They really have. But until next time, my friends, what I can promise you, movement either way, we'll be either moving to the eastern front. If we can't get past that Russian blockade, we'll be moving to the eastern front. If we can get past it, we're moving into Patras and Greece and also Istanbul. We'll probably use one army for Moria, two armies for Greece, and three armies for Istanbul to make sure that everything is secured. But until next time, my friends, bye for now.